What's going on, everybody? It's the Dreamcast pod. Heartbreak 03. My guy Zach.
Mxrwrld.
Let him know.
Dez versus the world.
Let him know.
In the building.
And today I kind of wanted to start it off with a hot topic.
Hot topic.
Let's go. Let's go.
How y'all feel about that, man?
Hot topic, bro.
How y'all feel about that man, Josh Giddy?
Oh,
how y'all feel about it?
Oh,
thoughts?
Rip.
Let me know your thoughts.
Okay, I seen that two things. I seen that this is old, and Josh Giddy was like, he was like 17 or something.
No, they were saying that the Thunder, like, they already knew.
Exactly.
What?
They had, yeah, they did. You didn't see that? They already knew. They just didn't bring it out.
The Thunder already knew.
They already knew.
Like, he was basically on some weird shit.
No,
like,
I didn't know that.
That's what they said.
They didn't have evidence.
I didn't see that one.
They didn't have no evidence, so it's allegations. But they were saying that the Thunder, like, niggas already knew that he was on that type of time.
But Shay be kicking it with him.
Bro, when they put that Lou Ratchet video, that shit is hilarious.
Shay's name.
That really is.
You know, bro, you know that the teammates was talking about it, bro. And he was still out there hooping.
He was still. No, I ain't gonna lie, I gotta give it to him, bro. He really must have not. So get out there and hoop the next
day. The 15-year-old. And going out on a
you got allegations of hitting them.
That's crazy.
It's still locked in, bro.
He's like garbage. That boy played like
and
garbage.
And they Snapchat every day, bro. They probably had a stream.
That's the thing. What? Why is they on Snap? Like, why are they on Snap?
Josh Giddy got to do better, bro. Like, how was you letting the hoe take the... Take a flick at you.
He flexing in a photo.
Oh my God. He over there.
That shit gotta be like she had to be over age or something, bro. Cause there's no way.
I feel like honestly that's some shit that happens in the Giddy family,
bro. But do you
like that's going way back.
And the parents, they're not even tripping about it, right?
But do you think he honestly knew she was underage though? Cause think about it, she was in the club. How she get in the club?
Josh Giddy got that. He got a name. So shit, I'm with Josh Giddy. She coming in no matter what. It don't matter. No IDs.
You can tell when somebody just like that young though. Like,
no, for sure.
Yeah, you could tell she was young, bro.
On the snap, like.
But the thing is, how did he find her? She's 15.
Bro, she
that shit really be pissing me off.
That got me thinking about, like.
That don't make no sense.
Was he scouting at the school?
I don't know.
Because Gooley would be.
How? They didn't go to school at the same time.
You gotta think about it, bro. Niggas get old and go in reverse. When you 15, imagine she really is 15. When you 15, bro, you just want to fuck all the hoes. That's like just like the bad, like just models, really, like 20-something-year-olds. Like
you just be shooting, bro. You
get older, and they want to start fucking with the little. They get some money. Wanna
that, makes
with, that makes
no listen to this though. I don't know if it's true, but they said the school that she went to was called Newport Harbor. They said Josh Giddy got 2 trafficking tickets in the Newport Harbor Beach area.
He's cooked.
They just in the
he's cooked.
They just in the local area and they just.
But where is that at? Like, where is Newport? Where
I think that's in Cali.
Yeah.
Oh, it's in Cali? Mm. So he not even supposed to be over there. So he going out his way.
Age of consent in Cali is 18. It would have been different if it was in Oklahoma. In Oklahoma, the age of consent is 16.
Damn.
Whoa.
But in Cali is 18.
My thing is 15.
And then 15 is nutty.
No, okay. If she was 18, it's like, all right, that's weird. She's young, but she's legal. But that's weird. That's weird.
Yeah. Okay, but I also, was it confirmed 15? Because I also seen reports of 17.
I did see some different ages. That's the thing. So I don't know. It could be 15, 16, or 17. But you never know when he started, like, originally fucking with her. So
I really wonder what that shit going to. They can't just brush that under the rug.
Nah.
Yeah. Like, it's going to have
but
to
they,
be.
But they are. But the way they're doing it, it's getting swept right under there.
They said it was probably other players doing that, and they just ain't like released that yet.
I don't think Shay was doing that.
Nah.
I can't.
Not my boy Shay.
No.
Not Shay.
Nah.
I ain't going to put that on his name, too. It's like hard evidence.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But all of them, like, I think Josh Giddy got in the league when he was young as, like, he was young as hell. The nigga was like 19. Yeah, he was the youngest nigga with a triple double.
He been in the league for a minute, like 2 years almost 2 years. Now.
Damn. But how do you crack? Like, that's genuinely crashing out.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, you fucking with underage, you just crashed out. Sure, yeah. You literally just crashed out. If she lets you fuck, you crashed out over some pussy.
Anyway, but you in the NBA, bro. You can get any badge on you want.
That's
the
key.
That's the worst part.
And you go to a 15? Like, come on,
bro. That's 15? What I'm saying. Niggas be going in reverse.
I don't get it.
You think Shay knew though? Like, it's hurting me like this. She knows.
Like, you gotta think. Like, do they have a relationship outside of the game? Like, are they talking?
They got to, cause they too locked in. They be looking.
They got to.
So you think Josh was like, hey man, I got this little 15-year-old I've been messing with.
But that don't even sound right.
That doesn't even, you can't.
As a nigga man, you can't let him do that. Even a nigga you don't even really care about.
I feel like maybe you'll sit on it for a while, but after a while you're gonna have to be like, nah, I gotta tell somebody else. This is too weird. Like a 15-year-old.
But the crazy thing to me is like it's not even impacting his game. Like he came out. He came out a couple days after the rumors and was hooping.
Oh, he still don't.
Yeah, he still doesn't care. He
I mean, he probably been doing it for a minute now, so he probably used to it.
It's been a thing that he's been doing. That's why he just doesn't care. Y'all seen the way he dismissed them when they asked him the question.
Yeah.
And if that just made him so guilty. Like when he said, like, I understand what you're saying, but
he don't know how to gaslight. He don't even know how to gaslight, that's so crazy.
Like,
no. I would have gaslit the fuck. Well, first of all, like, he's just weird, but I would have gaslit the fuck. What is y'all talking about, bro?
Come on, bro. I ain't even seen that for real.
He's talking about, I don't have no comment, but he did that shit.
No, for sure.
He did that shit. I was like, nigga, what is y'all talking about?
That's too guilty.
I would have took the fine and said, what the fuck is y'all talking about? He would have had to take that fine because he looks sus as hell. About, I don't got no comments, bro. It's bad.
And he looks kind of weak, bro. I ain't going to hold you.
Yeah.
Yo, bro.
He said he looked weak.
Yeah, bro. He just looks weak, bro.
Before the allegations, he seemed like a good guy, though.
He did.
He's a good guy.
Y'all
remember his draft day suit?
Yeah.
He had that blue suit.
Oh, yeah.
Like, imagine if, like, Austin Reeves, if he did that. Like, he'd be hooping LeBron
I'd
and
be heartbroken, bro.
Yeah, bro. Because he seemed like
I feel like LeBron would speak out.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
He'd be hurt on me. He'd be hurt.
He'd probably be off the team in a couple days.
I can't get your head on my face.
He can't have that attached to his name. That would actually mess up LeBron's legacy, for sure.
They really would. They're going to say that nigga LeBron play with a pedophile.
Yeah. And like he probably knew.
That's the worst part.
I'm surprised they actually not hitting shade with those type of allegations, really, bro.
I mean, I seen a couple.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's always going to be them niggas.
It's going to be
them. If you really want to see some shit, bro, just get on Twitter.
Just look at the comments.
You just got to get on Twitter.
Twitter is crazy.
They toxic on there.
Oh, yeah.
But what about Jordan Poole?
What happened with him?
That nigga just trash now. I mean, some players can have that shit on their back and be trash like him.
I feel like he lost his motivation.
He really did. But he got a chip. And then he got kicked off the team, basically.
Damn.
Oh, for Draymond Green, bro.
Wouldn't that make you want to go harder, bro?
It should.
It would, but you got to think, like, look, I got Curry on my team. That's making me go harder. I got the best hooper, the best three-point shooter in the league.
Because in the finals, he was hooping.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was smooth, bro.
He was smooth, bro.
But isn't, like, the goal to be, like, the best, though? Like, the best
He just on the Wizards.
It depends.
Yeah, like nobody winning. Bradley Beal, bro. They were just still.
Nobody's
there,
winning anything on the Wizards.
Yeah, like respectfully.
Yeah, I feel like at this point he's just hooping for the check at this.
I'm God, cause what? How much they give him? They give him like 140 mil or something.
Hey, bro, any mil.
Yeah.
Or so, yeah, any mil.
I mean, that still should be hella motivation.
That really should.
I know you seen all the memes when he first went to the Wizards.
Yeah, his face. bro, get a cut.
He was
bro.
Really demoralized. Like.
They told the nigga he hooping with Kyle Kuzma. He ain't, bro. That nigga did not care.
You had a few that you was trying to, you wanted to talk about on that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's get into that.
We can speak on that, man. That's
that's going to lead to, let's go lead to some good chats.
I just feel like in 2023, women feel as if they can just control the man that they're with. And that's just not the case. Well, for some, it might be. And I feel like the reason is that you have pushovers in these worlds that they might not look the best, but they might have a little extra cash, so they're willing to give it in order to receive, you know? And I feel like that just messes up the game. Like, that saturates the game for the guys that's really out here that are good looking and they know their value. That I feel like that's what hurts a woman, like a man that knows their value. That will crush a woman.
And, like, that should be a good thing, you know? Like, I feel like I always say it's supposed to be, like, team.
Yeah,
that's all, bro. That shit is so dead, like bro. I don't feel like women do not be trying to.
I gotta put in more every time.
Exactly. And they say like they want like a six figure. I'm coming out of. You know what I'm saying? Been working for a year.
You making that shit sound like they had like they just hand out six figures. I was like,
I've only been out of school a couple years.
If that,
not even. Bro, niggas can't even legally drink yet.
Exactly,
niggas can't
even
legally drink yet, bro.
That's crazy.
And the demands just be nutty. And it's just like, bro, just because you was fucking with 20-year-olds when you was 16,
which is insane.
And which is insane.
And how old were they though?
Like 16 when they fucking were like 25-year-olds, bro.
Why was nobody reporting that shit?
Like, that shit should be reported. In high school, we dead. Like it's dead at some girls who would literally admit to just talking like older niggas.
Like it's a flex. They flex.
That's why, like,
and it's like the girls like, dang, okay, yeah, they. Like, they embrace it. Like, it's sad. It's sad. Bro,
this is real shit that need to be reported. Exactly.
So now when they finally get 20, and now they talking to other niggas that's like they age. Nigga, we don't have 6 years.
We don't
figures.
Have the same experience that you
we don't have 6, bro.
You lived your life like you was 21.
We don't have
6 years. Didn't even experience the childhood. Like, bro.
I feel like it's also cooking the women these days, too.
Mm-hmm. It's social media for real.
Oh, yeah. Bro. It's social media for sure. TikTok. TikTok is the biggest app that's killing the women, I feel like. That and Twitter. They're competing for to take down women.
Do you think, like, the public interviews be making it even worse sometimes, too? Because, like, we be seeing it, we be knowing about it, but like, that's
probably. You talking about like the college shit where they just college, be admitted to like the crazy shit?
The dude at the college, like, bro, literally, he went up to the women, he was like, what's a trend that you hate that men do? She said, waves. Chat, waves.
How's it up, bro? Like, that's
the waves a hairstyle?
Yeah, it's a hairstyle, chat. Like, she said, waves. And then she said, men are just sassy. Like, that's a trend.
What like makes a man? What's sassy about that?
Sassy is just knowing your worth.
Sassy is just, bro.
I'm supposed to be just dumb brain.
Sassy is just standing your ground.
Basically, if you was mainly like if you was just raised around a woman, I guess you just sassy. Cause like I was raised by my mom, mm-hmm. So like if a bitch started talking crazy, we just finna argue or something. Bro, like I'm but like I'm especially if I'm Bobby. Right, like if I ain't do shit, then we finna sit there and argue because I ain't do shit.
But like, if you raised by your moms, like, why wouldn't that be a good thing for the woman too? Like,
you would think, bro.
Exactly, like you know what they need. Like,
exactly.
They really be. I don't know, bro. Like, I feel like they think their life is for real, a movie,
nigga, a dead ass movie.
Simply,
4K,
4K.
Matter of fact, not even a movie, nigga, a YouTube video.
This ain't High School Musical, bro. Like.
They the ones living the 2B movies, like, bro. 2B movies, like, I don't know, bro. Crazy demands that they ask in these days.
It's just unrealistic. Like, buy me a bag. Like, a bag?
Really, bro? But you gotta think. Really, we complaining about this, but really, the majority of the girls that are like that, it just be the bad bitches. But, like, really, the bad bitches, like, them not the ones you really want to, like, cuff. That's always been the theory, bro. Like, you don't want to cuff
the baddest.
You don't want to always cuff the baddest bitch. Like, you can fuck with them. You can fuck with them on the low tip or whatever.
And they always gonna cheat.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But you gotta get the solid eight, bro, with the good
mid girl with a personality.
And build her up. You can build her up, bro. Exactly. Build her up.
And you can make her yo baddie, like, make her yo baddie. It don't matter what everybody else think of her. If she, they think she mid, that's yo bad. You don't care.
Especially when you watch your girl, like, just come up.
Exactly. It's like, you seen where she was at when you first got her, and now she been with you. You see where she at now, you like, man, fuck what anybody gotta say about
my
you.
Nigga, bro.
Like, you know people that like move out and move in with a girl too early?
No, hell no.
You don't want to do that.
Nah.
I say stay with your parents for as long as you can.
Really?
Yeah. As long as you can, for sure.
As long as you can, bro. Especially right now, nigga.
Because I know because it may be tempting. I understand why they doing it. Because it's like, man, I'm with my girl. We got our own space. But it's like, you know when y'all argue, you don't want to talk to your girl. So, nigga, when y'all arguing face-to-face, you're not going to want to talk to her. You're going to want to leave.
That's why you got
to
know she the one before
really,
you
You got to know she the one because that shit way too risky right what now. You can fuck around and just be locked out of the house.
Exactly.
You can be locked out the house, but you're being sassy. Nigga, fuck about fuck that. Nigga,
like, bro, just snapping your shit, all your shit sitting outside the crib. You like, what the fuck? Like,
if I did that, like, cause she being sassy or doing some weird shit.
If you was to come in the crib and grab all her shit and throw it out, and she came home.
Nigga, you're sassy for that.
Nigga, she's putting you on Twitter.
It don't matter how much bills you pay.
Don't matter. You can pay everything from the rent, the utilities, the groceries,
the internet, nigga, all that.
Anything.
But if you don't want to fuck with her no more and you put her shit outside, now you're sassy.
Say, y'all, look at this sassy ass.
And then her friends going to be with her, too. They going to go out with her.
And you will never beat social media, bro.
Exactly, bro.
You will post your side of the story, you will get zero views.
Y'all, I pay all the bills.
I pay for
hair, nails, her clothes, y'all. They going to still say, boy, you sassy as hell. We don't care. That is insane.
Another thing, bro, I think... Bro, you'd be surprised you said this, but Mike, bro, man, when we was off, bro, he was talking about how, like, everything on the media, like, they always gotta, if it's a black person, they always gotta throw black in there.
Facts. Mm. Every time. Like, why we can't just be successful?
Like, why it can't just be a
young black man, first black man. Like,
why can't just be, like, damn, like.
Like, for some things, I say I could understand,
like historical,
historical things. Like when a black man on the moon? Of course. I want you to think about it. That's kind of crazy. Like, black people on the moon, like that's insane. But, like, somebody, like, I don't know, like, graduating a Catholic school. The first black person to graduate this Catholic school.
Like, it's just
congrats,
like...
It's just... Catholic is like a religion. Like, why we care about the skin? I don't know. Sometimes I could see it being, like, a situation where we got to press it. But it most of the time, it's not that deep.
But really, like, they're, like, black people don't... They don't, like... Cause they'll like they'll push that shit, like they'll get excited when they see some shit on media like that. But like really, it's like bro, he really just did something regular, and it, like exactly. It's, I'm like there's no racial, but it doesn't matter that he's black. Like
yeah, if you just do that shit, like a lot of people can do.
When they be pushing that, black people are like so like different. I don't know. They really make it worse on themselves.
Exactly. And it just looks crazy.
Agree.
Like
I agree, bro.
Just the difference. See, like that's so different than if a white person did it. Not saying that like.
It's so like bro tapping.
But the reason they really do it is just because of slavery. Niggas just instantly think of all slavery.
Yeah, niggas always.
We had to overcome all this, which I understand. But niggas, really, we didn't have to overcome any of this.
But you gotta think about it, bro. Like, it don't help that white people are still hella racist.
No, it is a lot of right.
That is facts.
And they be doing it subtle too.
But people did as be wearing a racist. Oh, that is the craziest shit ever to me. Like, bro, a dude will have like a racism type tat, a racism tee. Like, bro, how like. But me and Jamar was saying, like, this is dead what they talk about. Like,
cause you gotta imagine, like, like somebody that's like genuinely racist, like they go out, they see a black person, they just think in their mind, oh, this
hating,
right.
Like they just
they
hate
really
it.
Be vocal, like fuck you, like, no, bro.
Like just bro, unprovoked,
like just unprovoked. Go out your way.
Ain't do nothing. You could be walking, bro, just going to school and just chilling. Like,
bro, you could be having a best day of your life, man. You just woke up, man. They just gonna come and ruin your day just because, like, that's just their agenda, like, just mess with the first black person they see, just ruin their day, like.
And, bro, that's been passed down, like, it's just generational.
Yeah, passed down, because that's not no shit you just go about your day in the normal world and just start doing, because if you genuinely connect with black people, you will see, like, all right, some of these black people aren't too bad. I can understand, if you had an interaction with a black person, and that
but kinda, even them, bro, like.
That kind of made you change your judgment on them. But even still, like, you can't just use one situation for everybody, because everybody...
Niggas be so, like, the word is airhead, bro. Like, how you gonna have one interaction with somebody, and then you just put that on the whole race, like, the entire race?
Bro, and it's crazy that they envy black people enough, like, they lie about stuff that
yes,
they do.
Bro, like, yeah, especially, like, oh, bro, famous people, too, like, they allegations...
Like, why you gotta lie on me just because you don't like my skin color, bro?
It's crazy.
Bro.
What's up, y'all? We're here at Trusted Kicks, Jumpshot Classics. Just about to show y'all, man. I got a couple items right here with me, man. We just about to try to get rid of these items and acquire some new ones, you feel me? Maybe even get a little cash, show you guys how to dress, show you guys how to shop properly, and get steals, because that's all I do, man. That's all I do. The pieces I got are pretty good. I got a spider hoodie, Fragment Dunks, MCM bag, Versace glasses, and a Christian Dior hat. I mean, I'm not going for the low ball. I know what I got, and I'm willing to hold on to it, champ. Whoa.
So, I got a question for you, right? When you're looking through these racks, some people don't like looking through the racks. What's the mental, what you thinking when you're looking through the racks?
When I'm looking through the racks, man, I'll say that I'm just chilling. Like I'm in a vibe where like I'm not too rushed, and you know I'm looking for pieces. Like so I'm gonna take my time. I'm not in a rush. I feel like that's the best mental you gotta be in. You can't be in a rush when you're looking through these racks, man. You gotta take your time and really make sure you're not skipping over nothing, because you might skip over a gym. So yeah. Let's just see what they talking about, man. This is the biggest part of the vid chat. I told y'all I was standing on business. The offer was 180 for everything, chat. The hoodie alone, I need retail. That's 215, so That just tells you. It's cool though, chat. I understand. Everybody gotta make their money on. Feel me? So no pressure. But we gonna hoop for free. Hoop for free. Let's see the burner. Let's see the burner, huh? Let's see the burner on cam. You're shot. Okay. Oh my. Hold on. Is he him?
Ah. So I do got another nice topic.
All right.
I know y'all seen how the government was like, aliens are real.
Oh, yeah.
How you feel about that?
Bro, I knew that since I was like 10 years old.
Like, bro, it's not hard to... They out there for sure. Like, obviously. It makes sense, too. Because, bro, what is Area 51 for, fam?
Facts.
Like, they got to have something up there for it to be that.
That's where the aliens are at, bro. That's where they testing the aliens and they found out.
I think they were kind of pressured to do it because... did you see how they started getting videos and people were like, look at this alien backyard.
In the backyard.
This UFO or this weird beam in the sky.
And it all started happening recently. A hell of videos
a bunch of videos back to back.
And you know, they probably been out and they just getting like shown on the internet because people, they be doing that too, bro.
I feel like the government, what if they just using like UFOs themselves, bro? They just trolling the people.
I mean, at that point, bro, they probably is.
Like, they took the aliens' technology, mm-hmm.
Facts. That's facts.
That sounds nutty, but bro, the government be moving so crazy.
They be moving slick, bro.
They just seeing if like we seeing it, like if some people seeing it or not. Damn. I don't know. That could just be a wild theory.
But like, is it? Would it be like? You think it's like the movies?
If the United States, the niggas spend money on all kind of weapons. If they thought aliens were an actual threat, they would have like.
They would have put them niggas out there.
Like some preventative measure
So I feel like since they know, nigga, it make too much sense.
Think about it.
If aliens were a threat, they would have did something.
About the community, like make sure you don't fucking eat. Yeah, exactly.
So since they not a threat, nigga, they just told us like, all right, y'all know aliens are real.
Mm-hmm.
But they had aliens technology, bro.
They conquered. Yes, they crazy.
Bro, isn't that crazy? Like, the government literally just was like, aliens are real. Yes. Like, why did nobody make a big deal about that?
I'm telling you, they did that because they had their technology, bro. Like, they got people with their technology, bro.
Imagine seeing, like, an alien. That shit would seem like a fucking movie. Like, that wouldn't...
Like, niggas who work for the government, I don't think they even real. Like,
nah. They probably not, like, actually.
Half human, half robot.
Because, nigga, you...
If I see, like, an alien, like, whatever they think is an alien... Nigga, I'm picturing just a gray, skinless, big head,
like, do you think monster. The lizard people are real?
Lizard people, yeah, they real. They real, just like skinwalkers.
You think skinwalkers are real, bro?
What the fuck is a skinwalker?
Yeah, you don't know what a skinwalker is?
Show me. So what is it?
It's just like a person living in an animal or something.
And then they'd be screaming in the dark nighttime.
They would just, bro, just search up skinwalker videos when you get the chance.
They'd be like, help!
That shit is insane.
Bro, I seen a video where like the dog, they was like, we just left to see what our dog does when he leaves, and then they literally opened the door. Nigga opened the door and the dog was just staring there.
Imagine you go in the room really just staring out the window.
Standing on 2 feet, like just standing just... Just walking.
You would be kind of scary, bro.
Would you get rid of your dog?
You been locked in this whole time.
Or this nigga got to start talking to me or something. He got to explain to me, bro. Why are you doing this? And why ain't you saying nothing or gave me hints or
you
something?
You had to put that nigga life on the line. You might have to make that nigga talk.
Why can dogs learn our language, but we can't learn
theirs?
That shit is trash.
I feel like you might be able to, like...
Well, they were saying, like, with dogs, it's, like, more like your tone. Or the tone that you say.
Nah, bro, them niggas...
They know what you say. Like, dogs know...
bro.
Some dogs know exactly what you say, especially, like, German Shepherds, because they use them for canine dogs. You say something specific, they know. Some of their dogs do.
Like, my dog, bro, I'd be like, you ready to go pee? Or you ready to use the bathroom? He running.
It's because they hear that. It's like a trigger. Like, they hear a word like pee.
And they be hearing your conversations, too.
Looking
bro.
At you.
Bro, that's low key.
And they watch TV, like.
Oh, your dogs watch TV.
People think dogs are intelligent animals, bro.
For sure.
Back to the alien thing, though. So, do you think he was saying earlier, he was like, squids are aliens? Do you think squids are
just because they changed forms? Like, maybe the aliens pet type shit and them niggas done got in the water. They like.
I don't know.
They changed form.
Yeah, they be adapting to like their environment like to like if, hide away from anything.
If this was a thing and the squid came right, bro, yeah, he'd just, adapt.
Yeah,
to
yeah. Oh,
change
yeah,
his color and everything. Color
mm-hmm. Oh yeah. So I don't know. I wouldn't say they aliens, but like if aliens were real, they'll probably look like a squid. So I could see like why you say that.
I've seen that.
I don't know.
That shit's just a freaky ass.
I feel like an alien just. I don't even know where they would live on Earth. Like,
facts.
I'm trying to think, silly. Like bro, alien had to be on Earth. Where the fuck would?
And you think of Earth, you'd be like, damn, they gonna live in like California.
Who y'all think of the pyramids?
It's gotta be shit. Oh, like how they got there?
Like how the fuck, bro? Because like it really is crazy. Man, that shit don't make sense. But
fuck, were they really real? Like. Have you ever been to a pyramid, a real pyramid?
No, but we talking about like the ancient, the pyramids.
Yeah,
but
like, yeah.
That's, that's still standing up too, right?
Yeah.
Like, what about erosion, bro? Like, is it not, is it not bringing down the sand? Or
like, even erosion happens like when the wind be blowing. Like, that bitch, them hoes are like old as hell.
Yeah, I feel like they gotta be repairing them bitches.
But they be saying like the all the blocks are still like precise. Them bitches gotta be planted.
That's why I think King Tut was really real, bro.
Oh, yeah, King Tut was really real.
Hell yeah.
Like, they really got pyramids. Really
emotion, bro.
Nah, he was him.
He was really
so like, them
who,
kings,
who
they
would
really
be
human.
Like the King Tut of today?
My nigga Trump.
He gotta be. That's the only.
And it's not many people that can, like.
I don't know,
like, bro, he
Trump
really
had that much motion?
Bro, he really might get elected.
The motion King Tut was having, you can't obtain that shit ever in life.
As presidency, he had a lot of motion.
Yeah, as president.
Trump being Trump, he ain't got that much motion.
He can literally win again, though, with a federal indictment.
And it's so much different when, like.
I'm gonna vote for Trump.
Yeah, he might have my
bro, it's me too.
Shit don't went crazy.
He might have
it's a, nah, cause that nigga, that nigga Biden in there,
bro.
That
nigga, Biden,
that nigga old as shit. I never understand.
They gotta put an age range.
He literally walked like,
cause
that shit, fuck,
that shit 70 at least.
Like no funny shit, bro. They actually,
cause like, bro, if the nigga just died, like that shit kind of fuck, like,
facts.
Bro, if the president just died cause he's so old, bro,
and I feel like their mindset.
And he was running our country.
You know what's crazy on Twitter? I don't know finally, but I seen the video of what's his name getting shot. In
who?
Dallas.
Who, Kennedy?
Kennedy?
Oh, John F. Kennedy.
Oh, yeah, he's just talking about that.
They dead ass sniped that nigga in the middle of the city.
Oh, gosh. I don't want to speak on it, but the CIA, the CIA had something to do with that, man.
They dead ass sniped that nigga in the middle of the city. They got that nigga, bro.
What's crazy is, nigga, they got that nigga fucking death spot on the
with his lady right next to him,
bro.
Bro,
if you drive where he got shot, the X is literally on the road.
That's crazy.
And they keep changing the X,
bro. Yeah, they
change that. Why do they keep changing?
That shit was kind of weird,
bro. Weird, bro.
Like, why is that a mark? Like, this is where JFK died.
And it's just there that people people just go over there.
Yeah,
like,
niggas know that this is what it's for.
Bro, and it's crazy.
They really upped on that nigga in broad daylight.
In daylight.
She had his head in her lap the whole ride to the hospital. His brain.
Imagine, bro, like.
That is so crazy, bro.
You gotta get off me. I'm in my chat. I'm sorry.
But you gotta think, like, JFK, he wasn't even a bad dude.
Nah,
like,
JFK?
You would think they'd do this shit to, like, a nigga like Trump.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But you ain't seen the rumors, though? He was with Marilyn Monroe, cheating on his wife.
But that's
Marilyn Monroe,
yeah, bro.
Though.
That's what I'm saying.
See, that's when, I hate to say you gotta make an exception, but.
Low-key, but.
Marilyn, bro, think about her status at
the
time.
Bro. And it was like a big thing then, too.
Taylor
bro.
Swift.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bigger than Taylor Swift, honestly.
And it's so
bro.
Much different with like how at much social media we got now because it's so easy to just get.
Niggas, I know niggas doing numbers as far as cheating goes back then.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my
niggas
God.
Was
oh, yeah.
Numbers.
Because, nigga, there's no proof unless, like,
facts.
There's no
exactly.
Proof.
Exactly. Somebody was there and they knew you, like,
if,
oh, nah.
And if you lack that badly, bro, you shouldn't be doing this shit in the first place, bro.
Honestly, you just. Yeah,
you lack like it, bro. Like,
just don't even date
anyone. I know niggas was doing crazy numbers.
Had to, bro.
Man.
Bro, and then even in like one of the JFK documentaries, bro, he had a whole pool full of women in the White
just
House.
He was this player.
I like, think that they got to be over exaggerating. Why would they put that in the documentary, bro?
In the White House?
Sound good, bro. Like he was him.
In the White House, bro. Shit, they said, what's his name? They said, what's his name? Son was doing drugs in the White House.
Oh, yeah, they did. They said Trump's son was doing coke or heroin.
Biden's son.
Oh, yeah, Biden's son
was doing heroin.
In the I wouldn't even be surprised, bro.
Nigga, that's
to be honest.
Risky.
That's crazy.
Like, I don't see how niggas even come up with that conclude like
bro,
they don't got a cam in every room
blowing some gas
hey, I'll blow some gas
yeah.
But I'll do like on a balcony or
something
exactly. Look at the view like
cause at the end of the day this is the White House like, this
exactly.
Crazy like
bro,
I wanna tell
federal.
People like, I did this but like this still kinda crazy like I gotta watch out so I'm gonna be a little respectable heroin fam.
Like he was dead having a party in that bitch.
What? That's like a class 3 drug, 5 drug. Like that's some crazy shit. Hell no.
And the thing is he ain't even getting nothing happened to him
cause he just like
to him.
But why would like they? You know, like, you know his dad. You know his dad proof. Making him making sure he right. Like,
they have photo the president. Proof of this nigga fucking a bunch proof. Of strippers and shit. Mm. And he doing hella drugs.
But you gotta. Donald Trump was president, bro. That nigga on camera groping a woman.
Oh, you're grabbing him right by the little, you know?
Better, yeah, better eat. Right there, bro.
That's so crazy that these niggas leave the country, bro.
Grown ass man, bro.
I'm serious.
That was a camera on his really go bad. Bro.
Kanye might as well be president.
He really did.
Face, bro. That nigga's doing what Kanye doing, bro.
He really
Kanye
did could do the same thing. Bro, on cam, like, this is nigga, I'm supposed to depend on this nigga.
Like, bro, anybody could be president, which is crazy.
Kanye's hilarious, bro.
Throw Kanye in there. Let's do it.
Throw him in there, bro.
He might make more of an impact than Joe.
It's like they should just okay. have. They should be because Joe that nigga only know the old
shit,
ways.
Everybody get free Yeezys and shit.
That's what
that nigga's Joe know the old ways. Old
free Yeezys. I would. Hey,
like he was alive when racism. He was alive when racism was still there, bro.
Dang.
Like they got to get a nigga from like that's been experienced a little bit of both.
Bro, these boys are old. Like they was born in 19.
Like they not bro. Up to date, like, bro.
Exactly, 1960s, bro.
Them niggas are not up to date, bro.
Oh, that's crazy. Like, they lived through segregation and like, bro, all types of shit.
What do you know about me, bro?
All right, everybody. That was episode 3. Thank y'all for coming on, man. It was a good experience, good talks, good chats. Hey, drop in the comments once again what you want to say next, what topics you want to hear.
Like, subscribe.
Any questions, any comments, tips you got in the comments. And I'll see you in the next one.